on today's fly tying adventure. Today we're going to be tying the fox squirrel bug. It's a variation of the fox squirrel nymph. Excuse me. This is going to be my first time I'm doing this on camera, so pardon my iffiness about it. I will get better as time goes on. Anyway, I just thought I'd share this pattern. The main material that you're going to need is the red fox squirrel hide. This is where you're going to get your pretty much all your dubbing, your tailing. Sorry, it's out of focus. Anyway, let's get started. I'm going to start by adding 4 to 5 wraps of 0.015 lead wire. Helicopter it off. Next, I'm going to attach the thread. You want to leave ample room behind the eye of the hook to build up a head. And I'm going to jump forward over the weight and pull it forward just a bit. And work my way back to the bend of the hook. Here I'm going to snip off the surplus or excess, whatever you prefer to call it. And I'm going to reposition the hook at this point so that the hook faces downward. I'm going to take the tailing material, like I said, from the back end of the hide. And you don't want too bushy of a tail. Although if you make a bushier tail, it really doesn't matter. So I just took off like a pinch. And I'm going to clean off the under fur. You want to save this because it's going to be for your thorax. So I got about that. I still got some cleaning to do. I got to pick out some of the... There's some fibers at the far end that are a little bit too fine. Just grab those and pull those out. And that pretty much does it. Whoop. Knocking stuff over. So about there. Pardon the camera if it keeps like unfocusing. I'm going to probably just try and bring it back just a bit. That might help. Anyway. Once you're done picking through the tail, you want to measure roughly the shank of the hook. With a scud hook, it's kind of difficult in that sense because it bends. But really, it's just an estimation, so don't worry if it's a little long or a little short. The fish don't care. Alright, so I've attached it. Loosely. And now I'm going to wind back over the material, all the way back to the lead wraps. Being careful to keep it from rolling over. Keeping the tailing material from rolling over and causing the body to look a little funky. Once I'm there, I will reposition the hook so it's in a standard position. And I just pinched it and pulled it up. And I'm gonna snip off the surplus. For the ribbing material, I'm using a copper brown wire, small copper brown wire. I'm going to attach it at the back of the lid wraps and work my way back to the tail. Now here I'm going to dub the body. I'm going to put it, the recipe for the dubbing in the description below. Basically, it's 2-to-1 ratio. 2 large pinches of red fox squirrel back fur mixed with 1 large pinch of Harris Here Natural dubbing. You can also use Hairtron if you want a little bit of a shine in there. Here's things going on in the background. That's probably my dogs. Going in and out of the dog door. So anyway, I'm going to work the dubbing up now that I created a dubbing noodle. About 3 to 4 inches. And you want a slightly tapered body. And with dubbing, it's always less is better than more, because it's easier to, you know, I really don't see the excess, you know, however you feel like dubbing. It's a split. You can always remove. As long as you don't put wax on the thread, then you're pretty much fine with removing. So, really dub how you feel comfortable. This is a very forgiving fly, so you can mess up a lot and the fade will still catch fish. Now I just winded the ribbon material up to where the thorax would be, trying to evenly space them out. It doesn't really matter because the ribbing kind of just, fades into the body. And really it's just there for to secure the body, and it does add a little bit of color in the water. It'll shine better in the water than it does here. Anyway, for the wing case or the covert, I'm going to be using a feather off of a ruffed grouse. And I'm pulling these ones off the wing. I like the rough grouse because it's speckled. So, clear off the fuzz. And I'm going to take a decent sized chunk. Roughly about that much. I took about a sizable amount off the feather. About 20 fibers or so. And I work my way to the top and measure up, kind of estimate where how long I want the legs. And I just did a counter wrap on the bobbin. Right, so I just covered. Once I attached the front end, I just worked my way back. Here's where you're going to use the thorax, the under fur that you pulled from the tail. So just mix that up a little bit and dub it onto the thread. You might need a little bit more, so just use the same fur you used for the body. It's basically the same thing, just a little less spikier. Case forward and lock it in. And snip it off close. The wing case. What I did is I just, since this doesn't have any kind of hook or rest that I can put this on. If you're a left-handed person, it might be, you would probably be able to sit it on that, on the lever of this vise anyway. Anyway, I like the Norvise. It has a little knob that I can just rest. Anyway. I'm going to skip all that nonsense. I'm going to pull back the legs. And they kind of blend in, so you don't really necessarily need the legs. It's just what I've done with it, so don't worry if you don't have a... You can also probably just use some pheasant tail for the wing case, or the covert, whatever you want to call it. Snip off the... after a whip finish. What I did, I just did a whip finish. Sorry, I'm not used to the camera like I said, so... I tend to just do it and then tell you afterwards, so... I do apologize, I'll get better at it. Anyway, I did a whip finish. Two of them. And now I'm gonna pick out some of the really... errant fibers, or really long fibers. Just kind of pretty up the fly, I guess. And that's basically it. That is a fox squirrel bug. Hope you enjoyed. And I will get better at this as time goes on, sorry. Anyway. Thank you for watching.